Hey y'all, I'm going to talk today about what to do in response to cancellations, specifically with the viral agent that has been going around since 2020. Here's what you do. Well, you can get mad if there's a cancellation. You can get angry. It sucks. No musician wants to be canceled on. But when you're in communication with the activities director, don't get mad. Don't get angry. Be patient, be understanding, be compassionate, and calm. The reason is the folks at retirement communities and especially skilled nursing facilities and anyone that has health issues, and that's an elderly person especially that has health issues, COVID's a lot scarier for them. And so have compassion for that. Have compassion for that. And here's what I do. I say, there's no charge if you reschedule within 30 days. 30 days is pretty generous, y'all. So what that does is we just push it back. Push it back, like, usually after 2 weeks, a community will be cleared. Unless it spreads and they don't know how to, like, deal with it very well. It happens rarely. But yeah, 30 days to reschedule gives them enough time for everybody to work through the viral agent. You know what I'm talking about. And then to get over it. And they'll let you know when they're cleared, because they have procedures for all that. But don't get mad. Or if you do, it's okay. Like, honestly, I had a gig cancel on me today because of that. And I got mad, but I didn't get mad at them. I just got mad in general. It's like, this sucks, man. And I rapped about it to myself when I was driving. To nobody. To God. And I felt better after I did it. But I also felt really good that I didn't take it out on anybody that it didn't need to be taken out on. Especially the activities directors, y'all. They're doing their job. They don't have control over when their community locks down. They don't. They do have control over how they inform you, and this particular activities director, who I'm not going to mention, did not inform me with enough time for me to reschedule or to get another gig. But you know what? It is what it is, and my policy stands. Reschedule, no charge within 30 days. You know, rarely do I ask for a cancellation fee. The only time I ask for a cancellation fee is if they call me up and they're like, we're gonna have to cancel. And I'm like, why? And they don't give me a satisfactory reason. But the thing is, like, number one, it happens so rarely that it's almost like, even if you don't have a plan for that, you're still gonna do very well with this niche piano business. But number two, if they're canceling on you last minute, that's just rude. That is a rude thing to do. And furthermore, your chances of getting paid by being rude back to them are slim to none. Your chances of getting paid for that cancellation by being polite does increase your chances. And that's happened to me just a couple times. There was one instance where an activities director paid me because their administrator canceled. And that was a little bit difficult because they were paying out of their pocket. I was like, I don't know if I want to accept that. Like, I said, are you sure about this? Like, you don't have to do that. That's what I told them. But it made them feel good to do that. So I accepted it. I did. So that was a very nice gesture. Not everybody is that principled, I think. Maybe I should have refused furthermore. I don't know. I'll have to look at that. But I don't have a cancellation policy in place. You know, like, if somebody cancels on me super last minute, I'll say, like, oh man, that's kind of last minute. Is there, I'm not going to have enough time to schedule another gig to make up for that income. Is there any way that you guys could pay the fee? Like, I hate to ask that, but it's kind of a difficult situation that you put me in. I'll say something like that. I will. And that's a very reasonable thing to say. And they can either agree and go along with it and then pay you, or they can agree and say they're going to go along with it and then not pay you, which happens occasionally. But y'all, all this is very rare. I guess the other option is they can disagree flat out and say, no, we're not going to pay you. Like, F them. Who cares? Like, you don't want to work with people like that. There, that sounds like a toxic business environment. But that is the extreme minority of these places, y'all. It's a very rare situation. Sure, during 2020, during March 2020 and April, I wasn't getting any gigs. I was doing live streams for, like, 5% of who I would usually play for. And I did other work in that time, y'all. I got a real estate license, and I worked at estate sales, and it was fun, but uncertain. But now that gigs are back, I'm doing this full-time. I do not think that there's going to be another situation like the one that we experienced in 2020, where all these facilities were having to close their doors to visitors. There are procedures for going into these facilities, and respect those procedures, but they're nowhere as strict as they were even a year ago. So, I mean, even the cancellations that I'm getting, like, for that reason, it's super rare. Like, I get maybe one or two a month, and that's it. One or two a month. That's nothing. If I'm playing 40 gigs, then I'm going to try to reschedule them 30 days later anyways. And most of the time, they do reschedule. Sometimes they don't. Sometimes they just need more time, and it's a urgent situation for the community, so respect that. You know, don't get mad, y'all. Or if you do get mad to yourself and not to the activities director. It's not their fault. All right, that's my piece of advice for today. Let me know what you think in the comments. Follow, like, and subscribe, and thanks for watching.